What's going on, guys? Slovosh here. Wanted to bring everyone a video before this week came to a close. I was out of town earlier this week, so that's why I was not able to upload around Wednesday or Thursday like I normally do. So I apologize for that, but want to bring you guys just a little bit of gameplay here. I'm just going to do a live commentary as I complete the Hightown Patrol shared quest. You can see that I've barely done any of it, and for some reason, whenever you come into Hightown, I don't really know why it does this, but the rescued civilians thing, it kind of just counts on its own. Like, I haven't even made it down to street level, and I only have to rescue one more person. So, don't know what's going on with that, but I'm not complaining because that's just less things I have to do. So, basically, I just got to beat the shit out of some scroll captains, and defeat 800 scrolls. I'll show you my little tips and tricks on how to complete these faster. But I wanted to play as Ant-Man because he's very reminiscent of my past favorite characters, and after seeing the Civil War movie, I fell in love with them all over again. Of course, I went with the Hank Pym enhanced costume. It doesn't do a whole lot, just new voice acting, and some of his skills are a different color, but when he turns into Giant Man, he looks like Hank Pym, not like the movie versions. Excited to get the new movie variant of his costume as well. I'm probably going to end up prestiging him up while he's got a synergy for 50% extra experience gain. Just seems like a good time to do it. So, been thoroughly enjoying Ant-Man. Just a quick rundown. I'm not even going to open up the skill bar. These are the moves I'm using. All these would be rank 20 that you can see. So I'm doing tiny takedown. Okay, I just lied. Can't catch me is only rank 1. That's just his dash. 20 points red hots, 20 points fistful ants, 20 points inch high goodbye, 20 points into Bigfoot sighting, 20 points into definite particle, and 20 points into drone strike. Other than that, I think the only other 20 pointer is think small. That's just as passive for damage. And then the point dump is friends in low places. This is just a really hard hitting kind of boss killer type build. It's also okay at trash clearing, but if you're looking to knock out a bunch of weak guys, I would suggest using Bioelectric Blast. This move's awesome. I might come up with a ranged build for Ant-Man as well. If anyone is interested in that, just let me know in the comments below. But this video is just basically going to be me enjoying playing Ant-Man, and I have been thoroughly. So I'm going to take off now, and we're going to go kill some Skrull Captains. Looks like the people got rescued already. Like I said, you just come in here and that one kind of vaporizes itself. So I don't know why that happens, but it does, and I'm definitely not complaining. Alrighty, so we're getting out here real quick. We got to kill a bunch of Skrull Captains, so I might focus on that right off the bat. On my second skill bar, I have Friends in Low Places. This is pretty much the only time I use that is pre-battle, because it allows me to cast my AoE moves. Because usually what you're doing whenever you come up on a boss is you want to lay down the drone strike, and you can hold up 3 of these at one time, and then whoever you're specifically fighting at the time, whether it be a boss or just one really hard bad guy, you definitely want to hit him with both the drone strike and the red hots. But the red hots has a very, very small area. See how tiny that circle is? Just make sure that you're putting that directly on whatever boss you're fighting. So if I come up here on Kurigi or whatever his name is, I'm going to cast the drone strike, coming in for the takedown, tiny takedown, and then I'm also going to cast my red hots below him. Make sure you keep these refreshed and on him at all times, and they just pump out some serious numbers. So let's get some of this stuff going on. Okay, so right now looks like there's just a bunch of bosses. Whenever you have a cluster of bad guys like this, I will spread out 3 drone strikes and then use like the definite particles ring effect, the AoE from that, and then the Bigfoot sighting is obviously a gigantic awesome trash clear. So I'll usually lay down 3 of the drone strikes, which is why you need your ant bar to be full, so you can use the friends in low places to keep that full at any times. And I'll spread around my dot damage, and then wherever I'm going in, that's where I'll drop my actual red hot since it's so small. Now you want to make sure you're keeping up the Bigfoot sighting so that you have a boost to health at all times. And then basically whenever you're fighting one boss, you want to make sure you have both drone strike red hats on them. And then once you get in close and you're already hitting him with tiny takedown, you can do definite particle to really boost up his crit chance and his damage and stuff like that. So this will hit a lot harder because his shrink power base damage goes up by almost 70 once it's fully synergized, and that makes tiny takedown hit really, really hard. And the reason you're doing tiny takedown while a boss is getting hit by drone strike and red hots is because obviously it's two layers of dot, which is awesome, but then this also gains an additional 40% damage against people that are getting hit by drone strike or red hots. Ooh, I haven't beat Crossbones in this area yet. Let's get him. Just doing his dash. His dash is awesome. Come in with the Bigfoot sighting, immediate definite particle, and then as you're holding down, like you're click locking the boss with the tiny takedown, you kind of just weave in your AoE moves just to keep them on them. And then depending on the situation, you want to be doing these two interweave between all the tiny takedown hits. If you have a cluster of bosses, I would recommend doing Inch High Goodbye, then Fistful of Ants, because this will boost the Fistful of Ants up higher, and that does an AoE ring. But if you're just fighting one boss, I would probably do the Fistful of Ants first, and then make the Inch High Goodbye way stronger. So it just depends on your situation, what you're trying to do. Sometimes from a range distance, I'll just do an Inch High Goodbye, even though it's gonna whiff, and then I'll do a Fistful of Ants like across the screen. And then make sure you know which button you're using to keep your Friends in Low Places up, or people call it Flip, Friends in Low Places. So that's my acronym for the day. War scroll spawns up here now? What the fuck? Apparently I don't want anyone to go down in the sewers anymore. Alright, so I applied both dots. I'm gonna have Bigfoot sighting. That should clear out most of the guys. And do Bigfoot sighting on bosses when you're already punching them with tiny takedown, because it'll keep you in very close proximity to them. That helps a lot with damage output. And then like I said, if you're doing single target damage, I would do the Fistful of Ants, then the Inch High Goodbye. That should help a lot. Keep your two AoEs on him. You get into some heat, make sure you're medkitting. And then again, just make sure you're always benefiting from the health, maximum health boost from Bigfoot sighting. It has a 10 second kind of like carryover before you'd run out. Oh, there's a lot of Iron Mans around here. So let's see. Wow, two fighting. There you go. Excuse me. That's shitty. I don't really know why I'm focusing on the bosses. I really should be fighting Skrull Captains. I'll go ahead and knock that out real quick. So I'll lay down my blanket of AoEs, get my pets back up, and then come in and do a Bigfoot sighting. Should clear out most of them. So that's typically how I attack multiple mobs of guys. Is I'll lay down one, two, or three, just get a little blender effect going on, and then make sure you recharge, and then wherever the center of the guys are, you'll do your red hot ants. You can't see it, but it's like right here. So if I lure this guy in, I'm sure he'll start ticking away. But here's a Skrull Captain. Let's get him. Bigfoot sighting's always a good opener. You should clear out most of the trash. Lay down your two dots. Doing single targets, so I'm going to do Fistful of Ants, then the Inch High Goodbye. Anyone know what these little magazines are for? I think I got like a... It said I completed a quest, but I didn't get anything for it, so I don't know what's going on with that. Let's see if I can get to Crossbones real quick. Bigfoot sighting, followed by Definite Particle. I'm going to dash out of the way. I'm going to cast my two AoEs. I'm going to do single targets, that's Fistful of Ants, then Inch High Goodbye. Refresh my AoE rings. Dodge that move. And there we go. Crossbones Tactical Vest Gun Holder. Is that like another Alex Williams hair gel bullshit? Alright, so we got some. So right here, I inch high goodbye, and I'm just going to fistful hands from the back of here. And then I'll cast two of these. Recharge my ants with flip. And then I'm going to stomp on the boss, lay down my red hots because he's my main target. And my definite particle really boosts up my damage. And then we'll do some damage here. And I'm wearing a Midtown Industrial Signet ring, so it benefits me to dash every once in a while because it gives me like almost 20 something, maybe it's 28% extra damage. Shattered memories. What the fuck was that? Let's see what that was. If you guys don't know how to view what just popped up on your shit, just hit the V button and then you can check out your recent achievements. Obtain the shattered picture frame from Hightown Patrol. Okay, so I obviously am doing some kind of secret quest. I don't know, because I got this little, like, baggie, right? I had this little book bag. I don't know. They're, it looks like they're still coming out with shit, so I'm not going to get rid of anything that has to do with the Civil War stuff until they get the event kind of completed. That's what I recommend everyone else to do. I mean, if you don't have stash base, then you don't have stash base. But if you can hold on to it, you should. Because maybe there's going to be some kind of reward for turning in like all the newspapers or something like that. Oh, two captains in a row. Lay down both the dots. Come in with a big fist and then the uppercut. A little dash back and forth. Get him to stomp. Refresh my dots. Hit this guy real quick. Yeah, Bigfoot sighting is unbelievable. You basically never have spirit problems ever. Okay, so when you're taking heat, don't be afraid to move around a little bit. His dash is incredible. Go and bomb real quick. So finish off that guy. Yeah, red hots on the right click is definitely, I think, the way to, or not red hots, but drone strikes definitely the way to go for the right click because you can maintain three of them. Keep your friends in low places up. Has like a 15 second cooldown, so you might as well use it as often as you can. Wonder Gore clay. Definitely don't want that. It's, okay, so right here, see how I still have a shitload of the scrolls to defeat? Whenever you get this wave for the hand ninjas, get your ass down here and kill as many of these dudes as you can, because every hand ninja should be counting as a scroll at the time, so you can really, my friends will place this up real quick. You can really lay on the numbers there with this wave. You should be able to knock out a bunch of these guys. Spread your dots around. Wait for a big pack. Bigfoot sighting. Anyone that's stubborn, you can finish them off. Keep your flip up. Then you can just keep your spreading your three dots around. And then any single target guys, hit them with the ring from the definite particle. Bigfoot sighting, flip up. I'm gonna do an inch high goodbye followed by a fist for bigger AoE area. All right, looks like I'm out of ants. Gotta punch some guys to get some back. There we go, that should help me out a lot. Flip. Fistful ants, then an uppercut. For trash clearing AoE rings. Usually whenever Elektra comes out, she's got a ton of health, so I will continue to fight these scroll ninjas for a couple seconds to help with my 800. Just keep yourself close to her, but not super duper close. That way you can still maintain some of the killing of the ninjas, but right now I'm gonna just, I guess, focus on her. We're gonna do single targets, so we're gonna do fistful ants, then the uppercut. Alright. Don't know who's over here, but I'm gonna fuck him up. Okay, so that wave is awesome for getting your scroll numbers up big time. Who are they hitting? Oh, there's a captain. Alright, so we're gonna attack him like a boss. We're gonna do our two dots. We're gonna do definite particle. We're gonna do some dashing. We're gonna keep our dots up. And then we're gonna finish him off. Bench high goodbye. It's got an execute mechanic. Whenever you come into a big pack of guys, I don't need any of them because they're not scrolls. These guys, I could definitely use a kill on. Yeah.
Thank you, Pim Particles.
There we go, here's a boss. Work my way in there, hit him with the stomp, hit him with the definite particle, toasted. Alrighty, let's see if that was any good.
Who said nerds can't kick butt?
It's not good. Okay, so again, the Agent's 300 wave. This is a great way to get the 800 kills, too. So I'm going to dash into a big mob of them. The Bigfoot sighting. Should help. Hit your flip. Spread your dot around. Definite particle. Take out any stubborn guys. Make sure you're not afraid to medkit. Can't flip yet. I'm going to, as soon as I can. There we go. Ooh. Okay, yeah, these guys still do a bit of damage. But as soon as I come up, I'm going to do a Bigfoot sighting. Hopefully there's a big group of them. There you go. The AoE ring on that is just ridiculous. Hit him with the double dots and definite particle. Should finish them off. Alright, I'm going to do uppercut followed by a fist. Should knock out a couple for AoE moves. As far as that goes. Alright. Spreading around your dots. Throwing some low places. Uppercut followed by a fist. Should do some work.
I could have made it a lot worse.
Do red hots on this guy. Drone strike from here. Definite particle. Ooh, that's a big fucking sighting. Yeah, Bigfoot sighting. Yeah. So you can kind of see how you have to use his two moves to kind of tune it to whatever you're doing. Alright, now we're going to go get Nick Fury. He should be good right about now. His dash is really fast. Coming in just the right time. Apply our dot layers. Definite particle. Do Bigfoot sighting if it's not up and usable yet. There we go. So we're a little over halfway on both of them. And by both of them, I mean my shared quest that I'm doing solo. Here's a nice grouping of them. Yeah, usually. Excuse me. Usually between Bigfoot sighting and definite particle, you probably would be able to kill most trash mobs, but then throw down a couple drone strikes and maybe a red hot and just bounce around. Everyone should just melt. Because red hots does tons and tons of damage per second, but it's got a super small area of effect, which kind of, I guess, stinks. And you can't see it at all, which I still don't know why they haven't fixed that. And Ant-Man's mana, or his spirit, is never a problem. Because he's got two resources to kind of juggle between. And then his Bigfoot sighting heals you for like 70% or something like that. So here's a boss. I'm going to do the two AoEs and then my definite particle. Alrighty, let's see if we can't get this three-person wave here. We'll do his ultimate. This should melt these guys. I like to do my ultimate after I do a definite particle, because it should give you some extra crit damage, which which is always nice for when you're doing an ultimate to get the maximum amount of damage out of it, since it just pours on the ticks of damage. Might as well do this right before you hit your ultimate. Should help a ton with getting a little extra damage boost. Runs in low places. There's anyone left. Hit him with the stomp. Alright, so that's that group of guys. Ooh, here's the captain. Captain the particle, put your two AoEs on him. And just pound away with tiny takedown. Uppercut him when he gets low. Pretty cut and dry with the damage application, and I'm sure most Ant-Man builds are using something very similar. The only difference would be is maybe you just focus on one of the two AoEs, like maybe you just do Drone Strike or something like that, and then do like Bouncing Bullet or Bioelectric Blast for one of his, your like, what the hell did I just pick up, for your right click. I always get in the habit of whenever I'm fighting a nullifier device boss to just stop damaging him altogether or applying a dot layer, because I could attack like this dude nonstop. Like I could be over here fighting someone here and then click over there to do a dot and then still keep my other dots right here where I'm focusing. So that's a way of spreading damage too. Like if you're focused on one guy in particular, you can still drop some dots on other people while you're still fighting the main boss to help clear out things. I've actually completed a fair amount of shared quests that way, just by spreading the dots around. So like I'm focusing right here, but I could still drop a dot somewhere else while I'm still attacking without breaking my click lock, which is awesome about Ant-Man. You can really weave his skills in and out with how quick Tiny Takedown works. But just make sure whenever a boss is jumpy like that, that you're reapplying your two AoE dots. That's helped me out a ton, just for keeping your damage up. So like if they keep moving, just you'll keep getting your ants back, and then you want to make sure you keep reapplying the ant AoEs for every time they move. It's kind of a full-time job doing that, but if you can, that will keep your damage real high. Alright, I don't know why I'm still collecting these fucking papers, but alright, so I think I counted. Three more captains, let's go find some. Ooh. Alright. Friends in low places whenever you're low. It's got a quick recharge, so you might as well use it. Alrighty, there's that dot. There's a dot. Throw one over there, because it looks like there's a bunch of guys there. I'm gonna go ahead and do the stomp. Come in, hop this guy, do my full damage loadout to him. Reapply the dots. Uppercut, and gone. Okay, I actually need a cosmic medallion for these guys. I don't know why. No one over here fighting these two, but okay. Keep my distance on them. They seem to be doing a lot more damage now with the tuning pass. You can do kind of a ranged build, if you will, with Ant-Man too. If you're in a situation where the bosses are just a little too hot for you, you can wait for your Bigfoot sighting and your definite particle to be ready, and just keep your distance and cast the drone strikes from back here. Use your friends in low places to keep that shit going without punching or getting in the fray. And then you can do your uppercut and then do a big fist from a distance too. That's how you can kind of keep yourself alive in a really high heat situation. You can kind of turn into ranged Ant-Man. So it takes getting familiar with the build a little bit, but once you get the hang of it, he's got quite a bit of utility skills. That should kill most of them. Make sure you keep both your dots up. Go ahead and take out the other guy first. Hit him with the definite particle. Red hots and the drone strike again, and an uppercut. Should be done. Alrighty. So, one more, Captain. Alright, right here is a perfect spot for a Bigfoot sighting. Should Drax them sclounced. Remember the order of your doing things. If you're fighting single target, you want to make sure the fist is the second one. Okay, so this wave here, where it's the Serpent Men, they don't count as Skrulls, so I don't go up there and help with that. But once, and this is a very dirty way of playing, I hate being, you know, that guy, but that whole wave of guys comes in really laggy, and the whole area is really laggy because the dudes, as they come in, they have all sorts of like little flickering effects and whatnot. So it's kind of a taxing little visual for guys that you can't even tell you're hitting or not, and they don't count towards any kind of shared quest. So I usually don't go up there to do anything until a little bit after the Mindless Titan is out, which is kind of a dirtball move, but fuck it. So see how I'm applying the dot over there, but I'm still focusing here on this guy. That's the beauty of the drone strike. You can really maintain three of them, so you probably should at all times, especially when you have an abundance of ants just through punching. Because once you're locked onto a boss, besides dashing, you're basically never breaking that click lock. And what I mean by click lock is like, I'll try and do it to this. I won't have enough time to show you on one of these weaker guys, but maybe Crossbones, if I can get to him fast enough, I'll show you. Basically, when you have a left click, you click on them one time and keep holding it down, and then you can still maintain all, like, just pressing the buttons for all of your other skills. That's like, I guess, an action RPG kind of move from any of these type of genres. If you haven't gotten that down, it's super helpful for like really maximizing your damage, and it works really well in Ant-Man because his attack speed for tiny takedown is so fast. So now I just need to get like another wave or two of maybe the like Electra hand ninjas that are actually Skrulls, because I don't actually need to kill any more captains. I just got to beat a ton of Skrulls. So let's see. I don't think any of these guys are actually Skrulls. They're real hand ninjas. My AoE's on them. They still count as a Skrull captains, but they just have shit tons of health. That kind of sucks. Wow. No one's doing the Serpent quest. They really need to, like, get rid of that. Because even the Essence of Dread, which is what the Mindless Titan typically drops, it's worth, like, one blessing. It's not even worth the effort of like how much health he's got. I've heard they tuned down his health, so I guess we'll jump up here and see what it's like. But before, he took like, you know, 5 minutes to kill, and his Essence of Dread was kind of shitty. Okay, yeah, so they must have really nerfed his health because he's like going down quick. Okay, so they fixed him obviously with that last patch, but you still want to kill the bosses because they all have that like shared loot table now. But before they did that, Essence of Dread was kind of worthless, and the Snake Men don't count towards Skrull kills, so it was kind of just a bullshit quest that no one wanted to do. Still kind of is shitty, but at least now that they lowered his health, it's not as bad. This guy's dropping a lot of orbs. See if I can't get a god killer real quick. Uh-oh. Wow, they really nerfed Gorgon's insta-kill slash dash kind of thing. So just make sure you're keeping your two dots up. Weave in your other skills. Bigfoot sighting as soon as you can, but make sure you're close to the boss, and then keep your definite particle up anytime you can when you're in a boss fight. It will definitely help your damage output. Ooh, here's a bunch of guys. Friends in low places if you're out of ants. Bigfoot sighting usually helps clear a lot. Turn his splinter, nice. Okay, so gotta get over here. These bosses, go down two dots. Nice and close on this war scroll. Reapply your dot since he dashed. There you go. Pick up your unique and then move along to maybe these guys? I don't know. Lay down a couple dots there. Whoa. Alright, another newspaper, which is taking up my smash. Crazy. And a Bigfoot. That's usually my opener is usually my Bigfoot sighting, because it'll instantly spike your health. But it also, because of that 70% or 50% of your maximum spirit is restored. If you're dashing like cross screen, like really rapidly, like you can with Ant-Man, because this dash is very, very spammable. It's actually a really good movement for not being a teleport or a flight move, but his dash is quick, as you can see. You can move pretty rapidly with it, but it does cost mana. So usually whenever you get into an area, you can be running out of spirit. So if you instantly do a stomp once you get into a zone with a boss fight, you should be recovered on mana, like almost instantly, which is super nice. Alright, so I'm gonna do dot over here, dot on this main guy. Cultist incursion. What is that quest? Okay, I should have been down here doing these guys, because that should be the end of my quest. Ooh, these guys count? I don't think they do. Let's get here to this guy, get my hammer. It'd be cool if you drop the hammer or bodysuit. I need both of those, actually. Keep my dots up. Weave my skills in between. Make sure if you have a dashing boss that you're actually right up on him, like point blank, otherwise you will always miss your inch high goodbye. So like, kind of make sure you're already doing the tiny takedown and you see the numbers being applied before you do inch high goodbye. Wow, Silver Surfer just kills guys way too bad. So yeah, that's usually my combo. Bigfoot sighting, opening up with a definite particle whenever you go into a boss fight, and then immediately click locking them, and then drop red hots and a drone strike, or even drone strike, then a red hots, and then just start weaving fistful ants and inch high goodbye once you're point blank, you know, from them kind of thing. If it's like a big boss wave, like in Midtown where there's like six plus bosses or whatever, maybe you want to open up with just spreading out your dots a little bit and staying a little ranged. So see how much AoE I just did there. Then you can come in with a Bigfoot sighting and then a definite particle, and it should be most of the guys cleared out, and then it should just be the stubborn guys left over. Okay. I probably should kill this guy real quick, but I need to get down there to those hand ninjas. This is the wave that I was just talking about. That would be sweet to just finish off my numbers real fast. So, I don't know why I care so much about the orbs, but whatever. Alright, we're going in hot. See how much spirit I'm using. But it won't matter once I get here, because I can just stomp once, kill half the screen of guys, and then... spread those dots around. There it is. That's how you can do a shared quest real quick with Ant-Man. Looks like no one else is doing this right now. This is my favorite part about Ant-Man. I always keep this on second slot. What the fuck? Okay, so hold on. I think you gotta be dashed away a little bit. Or clear a second. Okay, guys. Okay, so apparently they're not buying into my whole shrinking bullshit where I can be hidden, but that's why I don't use a team up. If you guys are still watching this, that's a tip that I would use if you're playing Ant-Man, is especially for patrol zones. It's kind of nice to not have to like be doing something I don't know how you can still see me. That's ridiculous. They don't buy into it, I guess. Look at that. Alrighty. Well, apparently they can see everything. Whatever. So this is, of course, gonna make me look like a big fat fucking liar, because my shrinking skills don't work, and I can't be stealth like I should be. Still have not got an artifact that's worth a damn. Okay, but normally, you can come down here, like dash away to an empty area for a second, and then you can have on your second bar at least 1 point in close make the man for your defensive passives, but you can do the activated ability of this, and it should keep you really, really tiny like that. And then if you're really tiny, guys can't target you normally. I don't know why those dudes still were, but then you can sit here and you can do your opening of your boxes and cleaning out of your stash, stuff like that. And then if you need to just move around, you can, because no guys are able to see you. It's like a permanent stealth, if you will. And it's really nice to sort your stash and still maintain a good position on the map by doing this. Let's see. There's that. Yeah. So these guys, they spawn in like right behind me, but still aren't going to look at me. Okay, so I need one with fighting. There it is. Nice. Okay, so that just completed my gearing. That's another benefit of doing Cosmic Hightown, guys. If I'm not trying to farm this specific type of item, then I'm usually in Midtown. I just feel like the waiting for these 300 kill things is just too long for me. And there just aren't as many bosses overall. I know there's like 1 minute between the waves or whatever, but there's 5 minutes to kill those 300. You're waiting around. There's only two guys on the map at any time. And now that Crossbones is in Midtown, you're always able to like dash to a boss in Midtown. I feel like it's a better spot, especially with the shared loot tables, for getting in-game artifacts, I think, personally. But now that they nerfed the experience gain, it kind of took a shit overall for what I love to do in it. But Hightown, huge, probably the biggest bonus of doing this area, besides it, you know, completing a shared quest or something like that, is the fact that it gives you it gives you your challenge bonuses on your own personal uniques. Uniques drop like fucking crazy in Hightown. That's another thing. If you're leveling up a character, you should probably be in Hightown so you can keep your, you know, rank 20, rank 30, like uniques all on your guy. That's awesome. But once you get into Cosmic, the main reason you're in here is to get these challenge bonuses. So you can see that just over, you know, a couple days of playing in here, I've been able to get the challenge bonus of plus to fighting on every one of my gear except for my chest piece, which I just got. And I'm sure the rolls in this suck ass. So what I'm going to do is now that I got the challenge bonus on it, I will take this and I will body slide back to town. I will take this and I will go to my crafter.
I have a few new toys for you to check out.
And what the fuck was that? Oh, so that's what you can build with it. Okay, so ammo, vest, book bag. Okay, so you can find those pieces to get his tactical vest, which is pretty sweet, it looks like. But back to what I was saying before, you can do your gear upgrades to your new enchanted or challenge bonus kind of unique. I always keep the fighting ones separate. So those are pretty shitty rolls. I really doubt that I'll get perfect rolls like I have right now. But with enough rolling, maybe I'll be lucky. The main skills I want to make sure I have maxed are definite particle and I want 2 in melee powers. The rest don't really matter that much because they're not even in my build. So this is actually fairly decent now that I'm looking at it, because it gives me 9 to definite particle. To roll that would be kind of dumb. I might just roll with this, actually, as it is. I'm only losing -1 to the skills that I'm actually using. And I think the attack speed is way fucking better. Health is way fucking higher. And defense is good. So, okay. So, normally what you can do with that, though, if they sucked on the rolls under the gear tab, you can re-roll random unique affixes. It costs a ton of money, but you could re-roll those numbers until you get, you know, mostly greens or whatever. But I'm not too worried about close make the man. I mean, yes, it will be a tiny hit to my defensive abilities, but I think overall it'll be okay. So once you find that, you go over to the enchanter and you can do your blessings, or I'm sorry, your enchantments. So I like to do the cattle enchantment because it gives plus 2 to 200 health. Just a real easy way to get 600 more health between these three. And then do the physicals on slot 1 and 5. That'll help out a bunch. And then you can go over here and you can store the rest of your shit until you find 5 of them to sell them. So I just completed my gearing there with Ant-Mana.
Yeah, I had a rough night. What about it?
So he's still remaining small. So guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. I don't know, maybe I was rambling, maybe too much repetition of what I was saying, but that's my Ant-Man build. That's the one I've been using. I'm sure that's the one that's on Marvel Heroes Info. It works really well, especially once you get comfortable with the build and not having like a main spender per se, like Bioelectric Blast or Bouncing Bullet, which are obviously viable things to do. If you're going to do a range build, I would definitely do Bioelectric Blast, but Bouncing Bullet has like a non-labeled ability to keep you invulnerable as you're bouncing between the guys. So that's another, you know, way of thinking about things. If you're, I guess if you're in a harder content and you need to stay invulnerable for some periods of time, Bouncing Bullet's not a bad option. But with this build, you're able to really, really weave in and out of skills very quickly. You have 2 layers of dots that are doing tons of ticks of damage, and you're able to still do your tiny takedown and just really hammer out the bosses. So this is my build, my gearing. I'm using Fist of Apocalypse, doing a Cherubus. I got the Grim Reaper Medallion, Lizard Formula, Flag of the Scroll Empire. I'm doing a level 80 Axe. Lemuria's just for, I like the life on hit. And that's why I'm using the Lizard Formula and everything, because he punches so fast, I feel like he can keep himself alive really easy. Industrial Signet, obviously his own uniques with plus the fighting, max 60. Wait a second, that's only item 60. What the hell am I doing? I done fucked up, people. This is really hard to actually dash while you're zoomed in.
Would you like to see something I just invented?
Yeah, so if you run across that situation like I just did, make sure you fix that ASAP. Because right now, of course, I just moved it. His plus the skills, they're not as high as they could be. So it will get a lot higher, as you'll see. Once you upgrade it twice to 69, should boost his damage. And it just went from plus 2 to ranks to plus 6, plus 6, and plus 7. So that is going to help out a shitload with my damage output. And it should give me a lot more health. Okay, so make sure your gear is all 69 if you didn't already. Let's see if I can't do his little emo. I don't have the chat open. All right, now I'm just fucking around rambling. So I'm using God of Mischief. I've got critical damage rating with invulnerability core. And obviously I have a visual size decrease because it's Ant-Man. Mr. Fantastic insignia, health and melee powers. You could obviously go with anything with crit damage rating or anything like that, but I really wanted to make him more survivable. He can very comfortably do cosmic areas unless you're taking tons and tons of damage. But between the Bigfoot stomp and his base damage or health, you should be able to stay alive, especially with so much life on hit kind of thing going on. So that's that. I probably don't even have all my Omegas in. I've been earning a lot because he's got that 50% extra bullshit going on. So we will make sure we got the death lock program going on. So we're going to max these 3. We're going to do 10 and melt face. I Probably should take these back out. That doesn't matter too much. See if we can get another point in this. Ah, I can. No, I can't. Yeah, fuck it. There we go. Okay, so spin tech. And I got the three strength or physical damage type moves over here. And we got five into Xerogenesis, one into the shrinking Pym particles. Just because of the size decrease, obviously it's Ant-Man. Obviously, that skill choice there, that's 250 wasted points, honestly. I mean, yes, you're getting some speed, but for 250 points, the only reason I did that is because I wanted him to have times three of the small effect. So that's why I did that. You absolutely probably should not be doing that, but whatever. Do Rorschach training. We're doing 10 into the neural implant. And all the prerequisites there. Doing 20 into Hala. I don't have any ranged moves anymore, I don't believe. Probably should take these back out. And we'll put them in here. And then the 40 left over. See, I'm fixing this right in front of your eyes. This is good shit. Okay. Dump them in there. This is a great way of getting a lot of experience per kill. It's probably more beneficial than the other ones, is what I've come to find out. Harpy's a really good choice for low-level melee people with physical damage. 10 to Warpath, because plus to fighting helps with a lot of base damage and a lot of brute damage. Frenzy's really good for low-level melee people. Nothing in that. Caranthra, that's great for trash clearing, especially in like patrol zones, which is where I spend like all my time. Basically, I'll do the other zones for the shared quests, but 90% of the time I'm in this game, I'm doing like Midtown, Cosmic Midtown, just because you will get so much good shit just by grinding in Cosmic Midtown. I mean, artifacts don't drop nearly as often, but when they do, they're fucking great. So be in Midtown, kill bosses like it's your job. This build's great for killing bosses. So that's where I'm going to wrap up the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this live commentary, live play kind of bullshit. Did my shared quest for Hightown. This build could be applied to any of those different situations. I'm going to try to make a range build, and then I might try to make some videos of like a really, really defensive Ant-Man where he can do like cosmic danger rooms. And then I'll see where that goes. But if you guys like this video, leave a thumbs up. Leave some comments, questions below. I'll try to do my best to answer them. I would say Ant-Man is probably my number two or three. Probably right now my number two. Main. Obviously, Main is still Mr. Fantastic. Emma Frost is amazing right now. Ant-Man, because of the movie, it's just makes sense to play him right now, especially for if I start doing like prestiging him kind of thing. I'd like to get him to red prestige. I think that'd be pretty cool. But that's the video, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Subscribe if you're just checking out the channel. I know this is really late in the video. If you're still here, you guys are fucking awesome. I'll see you next week, I suppose. See ya.